Glad Day Bookshop, right on Yonge Street, just north of Wellesley, right here in Toronto. It's a great store with a lot of merchandise for the discerning gay man in your life, or whoever. For instance, let's take a look at the new releases wall. But I'm just curious as to what it would say about Toronto. What does a Spartacus guide say about Toronto? Well, let's not care. Let's think about vacations, because it's middle of winter, and pretty soon we're going to want to see a lot of this walking around. So why not start by purchasing a Spartacus guide right here at Glad Day Bookstore, where they have all the gay and lesbian literature you could possibly want. Very handy. But look at this wall of new releases. This is incredible, some of the stuff that's coming out. Here's a book about the cult of Rocky Horror Picture Show, which I think is interesting, especially now that Laverne Cox is thinking of taking the role of Frankenfurter for a TV movie. What else do we have here? Lots of Grace Jones has published an autobiography. Check out Drew Rosum's review of this very same book on this very same website. Oh, here's my buddy Brad Fraser, his new play, Kill Me Now, about a father with a disabled son. Very successful production in London, England last year. This one looks very interesting. Sex and the Weimar Republic. I always wondered what was happening before those Nazis came in. And the incredible Denise Benson book, Then and Now, A History of Toronto Nightlife. If you're anything like me, you were going to clubs in the 80s, you're going to want to read that book. There's lots of good books in this bookstore, but I'm particularly fond of this one. I wonder why. I heard it's a really good read. Let's go over to the gift wall, because that's where all the expensive stuff is. And there's Scott D'Agostino, store manager.
Hello.
Scott.
Yes.
There's a lot of hunky boys on this wall.
Oh, there's amazing stuff on this book. I mean, the hunky men are obvious, but we've also got amazing things like this photo retrospective of a summer camp for trans kids, where they allow gender-neutral children to sort of live out the summer as they would want to. And it's an incredibly lovely book.
That's cool.
I always recommend this one.
Of course, being a redhead.
The Redout 100. It's pretty fantastic.
You know what I love? The blue background, because it really brings out the beauty of the redhead.
It does. It pops. He's fantastic. And there's 99 more of him in there.
What else you got?
Local photographer, Kenny Yip. The Men of Inked Kenny. You will find many of our friends and neighbors in this book.
A lot of guys that we've had sex with are in this book.
There you go.
Like,
I always, one of the things I love about photography books is that it's like a great Christmas gift or holiday gift is giving someone something that they would love but wouldn't necessarily splurge on themselves.
Right.
Very few of us are going to run out and drop about 60 or 70 bucks on a big, gorgeous photography book, but when you give it to someone, it's something they can love forever.
It's great stuff, yeah.
Yeah. This is a great one. The company that makes a lot of this photo books is called Bruno Gemunder. They're based in Berlin.
Mm-hmm.
And once a year, they kind of take all their porn money and do something worthy with it. Last year it was a book called Positive Pictures, which is a visual history of the AIDS movement, or the AIDS activist movement, I should say.
Wow.
It's full of graphics and stuff from the 80s and 90s and beyond, and how we reacted and the postering campaigns, and it's just great stuff. And this year they did The Art of Looking, which is a tour inside the home of art collector Charles Leslie. He turned his New York apartment into the Museum of Gay Sex. And the book through and documents all the drawings and photographs and things he's collected in his home, along with, of course, a lavish thing. But here's an example of one of the walls in his apartment.
Wow.
And
that's a lot of penis pictures.
There's a lot of cock in this man's house.
Yeah.
And it's all lovingly documented in this book.
That's nice.
And then finally, another fun gay book.
Ah, my favorite.
Briefcake, with a foreword by the Lady Bunny, because of course it's the Lady Bunny. But it's a wonderful tour of sort of 1950s and 60s Americana Beefcake, all the classic posing straps, and just really kind of a really strange but fun era.
Beautiful stuff. I love the color photography of that period.
Mm-hmm.
And as well, I like the men are very natural. They're not so sculpted, although the one on the cover is rather sculpted. But there's a lot of that natural beauty. What's mm-hmm. Full Frontal by Dylan Rosser?
Full Frontal is kind of like, you know when a band you like puts out a greatest hits album?
Yeah.
This is kind of Dylan Rosser's book. He had three previous books, but this one is now in paperback, so it's cheaper if you need something
nice, equally
lavish, but a little easier on the pocketbook. But it is probably the opposite of what you were just saying, in that these are very, very sculpted men.
Yeah, well, they're pretty good. I'm not complaining.
He likes the lighting. And one of the things I like about his books, too, is that his models are a little more diverse than usual. There's, like, black and Asian men in this book, which we just don't see enough of in a lot of this photography
stuff. I'm noticing that's great. Dominicanos.
Yes.
Which looks like that's a hot thug there. And what else do you have there?
There's a couple of fun ones. There's I love this. The Teaches of Peaches. It's a coffee table book devoted to Peaches, who is, of course, fabulous. And right beside it, a Duke University text called A Queer History of Fashion, From the Closet to the Catwalk.
Nice,
and
that's good.
Just that. There is amazing stuff in there. And also, panning a little up here, Joe Boys is a great big book of cartoons from Joe Phillips. He's in California. And he draws, he's been doing this for about 20 years now, and he does amazing illustrations.
You know what else? You got the big penis book in 3D.
In 3D.
Like, I bought a copy before the 3D one came out. Now I'm kind of mad, because I think the 3D one would be really fun.
Yeah, they took all the black and white photos and made them stereoscopic. And what's hilarious is that's from Tashin, and Tashin has a wonderful gift of taking the stuff that they have the rights to and just repurposing it again and again.
Yes.
Like in... You know, you have the 3D penis book, and then if it's too big to carry around, they've introduced
the little book of big penis. That's so
this one is a mere $12, and it's just hilarious how Tashin keeps finding new ways to spin the same material.
And you can fit it in your purse.
Exactly. And and right beside it, I should pick one of our staff picks.
Forever Butt.
Forever Butt, the late lamented Butt magazine. They're online only now, but yeah. I miss the pink paper little pamphlets. They got in trouble a few years ago when a mother in Vancouver sued them. And it's actually one of my favorite stories because the case got thrown out. She was suing Butt for emotional distress, and the judge essentially said, "Well, madam, you picked up a pink magazine entitled Butt. What did you think would happen?"
I thought it was full of nice pictures.
but Butt is great because it's full of fantastic interviews with artists and provocateurs like Bruce LaBruce and people we adore.
Very hot pictures.
Great pictures. Yeah.
Very hot pictures.
So Butt is fantastic. And it's got a great big staff pick sticker on it.
Oh.
Like many, many of our books in the store, we have a whole staff pick wall over there where myself and the rest of the gang are glad to have our favorites that we promote.
Nice. And then you got more like cutesy stuff here. V is for Vulnerable and this Alice Walker thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Look at this really cool comic book.
That is fantastic. That's from a company called Northwest Press. They're based in Seattle. And they do queer comics. And this one we love because Bold Riley is a queer brown girl who rides on horseback and fights monsters and saves villages and romances the girls.
That is beautifully
and
produced.
It's beautifully produced, and the art is fantastic. They've got about 4 issues now in a big trade paperback. And Bold Riley is just a fantastic heroine.
Now, there's not just pictures of hunky guys. We can also get a book about Canadian cocktails, which is terrific. Right behind you is Broadway musicals, which, you know, if you're not interested in skin, there's Broadway.
That's right.
I'm interested in both. And plus, you also have non-book things.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for instance, here's something. A George Takei candle. Gotta get this for my boyfriend.
This is from a company in the States called Flaming Idols, and they produce little devotional candles.
Who else do we have in here?
And there are amazing people.
Who's Bayard?
That is Bayard Rustin, who is a gay man who helped organize the March on Washington in 1963. He was Martin Luther King's right-hand man, but because he was gay, they marginalized him. And kept him quiet. It's one of history's great injustices.
So
the
we can
way he was
learn
treated.
About history through these candles.
Exactly.
Like, who's Kate?
That's an odd one. That's Kate Bush.
Kate Bush.
I'm not sure how she managed to get in the line, but at the same time, she has such a huge, huge gay following. Chris Steves is a local DJ. And do I know him?
A fairy plate. That's only $20. Really cool. What else do we have here? Oh, look, a little gay plate. It's very nice. And a beautiful rose. I mean, these are gorgeous for Christmas.
And the name of the company is Pansy Ass Ceramics, which I love. They're making the plates as fast as they can because they got a shout out from Alan Cumming on Instagram.
There you go. And loved it. So you're not the only sole distributor. Or?
No. But we're happy to promote them in our store.
Good. Mm-hmm. A lot of great stuff for Christmas, obviously. I mean, why go anywhere else? You come here and buy all your Christmas gifts.
There you go.
There you go. Thanks, Scott.
Thanks, Paul.
All right.